Boeing is facing new allegations about its 737 MAX jetliner. It was grounded 18 months ago after two deadly crashes. This week, congressional investigators provided the most scathing account so far of what went wrong, calling it a, quote, horrific culmination of errors. Here is Chris Van Cleve.
As far back as 2012, multiple Boeing engineers and test pilots were raising concerns about the automated MCAS anti-stall system on the 737 MAX, the very system at the center of the two crashes that killed 346. But those concerns were not thoroughly investigated or dismissed, and were never shared with the FAA or Boeing customers. That from a new report from House Transportation Committee Democrats that is scathing in its blame of Boeing and the FAA.
I think this report is a roadmap for the changes that are needed.
Committee Chair Peter DeFazio is finalizing FAA reform legislation.
Well, I'm astounded that we can have a system where both Boeing and FAA find that they were compliant with the process, and yet 346 innocent people died. That means the process doesn't work.
The 245-page report argues Boeing employees made a conscious effort to conceal the existence of MCAS to avoid potential delays from additional FAA scrutiny and the possibility of additional training requirements. As for the FAA, the committee did not mince words. The FAA failed to ensure the safety of the traveling public and failed in its duty to hold Boeing accountable. The agency did not ask enough questions or sufficiently scrutinize Boeing responses. Michael Stumo's daughter, Samia, died when Ethiopian Flight 302 crashed last year.
We don't trust that the plane is going to be safe. We've already seen this movie before where everyone assures the public that it is a safe plane, but they won't show us.
The FAA says it's committed to advancing safety and looks forward to working with the committee to implement improvements identified in this report. Boeing says, we have learned many hard lessons as a company from the accidents and from the mistakes we have made. Chris Van Cleve, CBS News, Washington.